Watch out! Don't!
How many times since we were small have we heard those warnings? I think my earliest memory was someone, my mother, telling me if I did that, I'd get hurt. Well, today we're going to talk about this topic, safety, again. But we're going to have some fun as we do. Oh, you doubt it? Well, give me a chance. How many of you have ever played What's Wrong with This Picture? Well, in case you haven't, all you do is look at a picture in which one or more things are wrong, and you quickly try and figure out what's wrong and what would make it right. Then we'll repeat the scene and show it to you the safer way. Okay? Then on with the first scene. I'll bet this looks correct, but there's something wrong. Can you find it? Let's watch the safe way to handle this.
Carlos, can you come and help me?
Cleaning the spill is great, and you must do that. But this employee also called for help to guard the area, waited until it arrived, and then went for the mop. If you're not right near a phone, call over the first employee you see.
I'll bet that was trickier than you thought. Most anything left in an aisle where it shouldn't be is dangerous to our customers as well as our employees. What's wrong in this next scene?
Find anything? If you notice the binding strap left on the floor, you are correct. First, make sure the area is safe, then do your work. What about this scene? People who aren't looking can trip over anything they're not expecting.
We're now going to talk about lifting. Incorrect lifting is one of the biggest causes of accidents at Toys R Us. But before we continue with what's wrong with this picture, let's cover the important points of lifting. First, whatever you're lifting should be as close to your body as possible. So, place one foot to the side and one to the rear. Keep your back straight, bend with your knees. Hold the corners for a good grip, but before you lift, test the load. If it's too heavy, get help. Since your knees are bent, your back is straight, lift with your legs. If you need to turn, turn with your feet, not your waist. And set it down just the same way. Close to your body, bend the knees, not the back. What's wrong here?
One foot to the side, one behind. Bend the knees, grasp the corners, test the load. Gently lift with the power of your legs holding the carton close to the body. When you're putting the carton down, it's just the reverse. I'm going to give you a clue for the next few scenes. Close to the body. That's all I'm going to say. Now, I know we haven't covered lifting above the chest, but I did give you a hint. What's wrong in this scene? This is the safer way. See how he shifts his grip to get under the load? Then, like a weightlifter, he uses his arms and the power of his legs to lift the carton. Lowering it would be done the same way. What's wrong here? Get as close to the carton as possible, bend with the knees, get a good grip, and lift with the power of your legs. It's easy not to hurt yourself when you know how to lift. Our next safety topic is ladders. Let's watch this employee and figure out what's wrong with this picture. I will tell you, there's more than one mistake here. What's important here is that he locks the ladder and makes sure it's stable. When he climbs up, he doesn't climb beyond the next to the top step, nor does he lean further than his belt buckle. Instead, he moves the ladder closer to the merchandise. Do you know why this is unsafe? Only when you're facing the ladder can you hold on. What's wrong this time? Bringing merchandise up or down is no reason not to hold on to the ladder. If you can't do it safely alone, get help.
Carlos, to your register, please. Carlos, to your register.
Can you find anything wrong here?
Carlos, to your register, please. Carlos, to your register.
Ladders left in the aisles are dangerous because people can trip over them and children may climb them and get hurt. Just a few more points about ladders. If it's 8 feet or less, carry it upright. Over 8 feet, and it should be carried end to end by 2 people. I'd like you to think about our fixtures now and how we display and store merchandise. It's probably no news to any of you that cartons not neatly stacked or tall objects that aren't secured or at least leaning away from where they could fall could be dangerous. Just one look at the storeroom or the aisles or the perimeters out on the sales floor and you can figure out what's in danger of falling and what's not. But what about the things that are not so obvious? Excuse me, sir, but I don't think the Three Stooges are looking for anyone right now. That's better. Also, when merchandise extends too far from the shelf, it could trip someone. What do you see that's wrong here? Empty pegs are dangerous because children could be hurt by them. How about this scene? Can you spot what's wrong here? We hope we never need these, but in case we do, don't block the emergency exits. Also, do not place merchandise next to the sprinkler heads. If there were a fire, the water would be blocked from reaching the fire, so merchandise must be at least 18 inches below the sprinkler heads. And never stack merchandise near the ceiling heaters or lights, because that can cause a fire. Now, as long as we're on the topic, would you know what to do in the event of an emergency or a fire? First, don't handle it alone. Pick up the store intercom. For a fire, say red 99, red 99, red 99, and the fire's location. For any other emergency, such as a serious injury, say 99, 99, 99, and the emergency location. A manager will respond. Do not scream fire, because that could start a panic. And remember, smoking is never permitted in the storeroom or on the sales floor. Okay? Are you ready to continue playing what's wrong with this picture? Then let's turn our attention to box cutters. What mistakes can you find? I'll give you a hint. There are at least 3. Extend the blade by tapping the opposite edge on the carton. Make the cut away from you, not too deep, so the merchandise won't be damaged. Never use the box cutter to pry open a box, because the blade could snap. Use your hands instead.
What's wrong here? The box cutter belongs with you. So after you close it safely, take it with you. We're now at the last part of the game, where we'll cover safe ways to bring merchandise to the floor. So, what's wrong with this picture? Either make two trips, or use a U-boat, flat truck, or handcart. Do you know what's wrong here? Pulling the U-boat or flat truck allows you to see what's around the corner and gives you more control. Hand trucks are easier to push, but slowly because it will round the corners before you do. Well, how did you do? Were you able to pick out the errors? If you didn't do that well, ask to see this video again. You'll see that you learned quite a bit. But no video can prevent all accidents. Our best defense is you. So when you see something unsafe, correct it. If you see an employee doing something unsafe, demonstrate the safer way. If you see a customer doing something unsafe, explain to the customer that what they're doing is dangerous. They will appreciate it. And if you don't know the safe way to handle something, ask. Of course, if anyone is injured, report the injury to store management immediately. So from now on, let's be careful out there.